My name is Matt Dursh. I am a professional engineer and I design bridges, and we're going to be reviewing 1 month of progress at the Francis Scott Key Bridge Recovery. We're going to be talking about the three different spans of the three-span continuous truss, and we're going to start in span 19, which is where the work first mobilized. In span 19, the first thing they did was is they started working on this section of the truss that fell nice and horizontal, resting on the mud line. This is one of the perfect spots to start and just get going on this recovery effort. It allows the crews to get familiar with the specific sites. It allows the work plans to get fleshed out. Around March 29th, they had crews working on this thing. And by April 9th, they had removed about 5 to 6 sections of the truss. Currently, that's where they're working right now. They're clamshelling out that, getting ready to remove the remaining section that is sitting below the waterline. At span 17, here they had a similar work plan needed as to span 19, except the proximity of the truss adjacent to the dolly introduced complications because you did not want to influence what was happening on the dolly with your actions on that truss. But they were able to identify the location right here is about where the dolly was starting to support a section of the truss. And you can see by April 15th, they had removed basically all the sections that they can above the waterline. Now they're going to be moving that dredge over there to be removing portions of that concrete deck to make way for the lift that's going to extract what is sitting below the waterline. So span 18, the work plan for this is the main span, was broken up into several different sections with the top priority to be opening that limited access channel. And that is where span 18 section 1 was sitting. And this is when we started seeing some of these really big crane picks coming out of the Chesapeake 1000 crane. And guys, just look at this. By April 16th, they had most of the truss out of the water where that limited access channel needed to be. We see some really interesting sonar images here at the top here, March 31st, before any of the extraction of the truss or the concrete began. And then looking at the bottom, April 18th, after they removed all the steel. Still a lot of debris on the bottom, a lot of those floor beams that supported the concrete deck. All right, so span 18, section 0. This is the section that was sitting on top of the pier, and you can see how it kind of cradled down, crumbled all around the pier. Very complicated removal here. Things would be shifting as you cut them. You need to support it. You don't want to introduce dynamic effects on your crane if you can avoid it. And so really just incredible work that was done here. They had a long lift going on here. They actually had to extend well into the night here to make this extraction. All right, let's run through some of the numbers behind this operation that have occurred over the last month. Great news in terms of vessel transits. In total, 171 commercial vessels have transited one of those four temporary access channels, including 5 of them that have been waiting to depart since March 26, being trapped behind the Francis Scott Key Bridge wreckage. Progress on the dolly itself is moving pretty well. 137 containers have been removed, and they've identified about 180 necessary in order to provide a full accessible work zone for them to rig up and actually remove that 4,000 ton section of truss sitting on the dolly. Just a lot of people who've been working on this thing, over 1,000 individuals with 53 total federal, state, and local agencies, and a huge amount of stakeholders involved on this recovery. As we know, there's 50,000 tons of wreckage, and so far they've removed about 3,000 tons of that wreckage. Now keep in mind, about half of that is probably the concrete deck itself, with the other half the actual steel truss. So there is still a very long way to go in completely removing the wreckage of the bridge. They have mobilized 36 barges, 27 tugs, 22 floating cranes, which, by the way, 22 floating cranes is a massive flotilla. They have 10 excavators. A couple of those are on the water, but the majority of those are at Sparrows Point processing that debris and wreckage. One dredger, which we've seen putting in a lot of work. Now, aerials, they've been getting a lot of aerial information. And in terms of the construction crews out there, the salvage crews, aerials provide so much valuable information for, one, just staging where all your equipment is. It shows you the progress that you are making. It really just provides that bird's eye view that is just so helpful in planning out the construction work. Thank you very much for watching this video. My name is Matt Dursh. I'm a professional engineer and I design bridges. Make sure you like this and make sure you subscribe to my X or my YouTube. Thank you very much.